My name is Christine.
My name is Rohit.
My name is Hayden.
My name is Eamon.
My name is Kia.
So the clinic that I work for is Eliza Shirley.
I work at Streetside Clinic at Prevention Point.
I work at St. Raymond's Clinic.
I work at Salvation Army Clinic.
I volunteer with the ART Clinic.
Eliza Shirley is run by Salvation Army, and it's one of the largest women and children's shelter in the city of Philadelphia.
We meet the social and medical needs of individuals coming in to the Student Exchange at Prevention Point.
We serve chronically homeless individuals who are over 55 years old and have chronic illnesses.
Underserved populations from the area can go and seek help for their various drug and alcohol rehabilitation issues.
The ART Clinic aims to provide health screening to low-income individuals with intellectual or developmental disability.
We are student-run clinics that is supervised by our physician, so it gives us the opportunity as medical students to conduct interviews in our first and second year, which is a big deal for us when we're usually stuck in a library.
Every time that I go to Streetside Clinic, I have the opportunity to gain meaningful relationships with patients and then learn directly from them.
I really love the tighter bonds we create with the patients, and the patients really love being part of our teaching aspect of the clinic, and we are truly grateful for their trust and their willingness to take part in their lives.
We're able to not only see patients at the clinic, but also train first-year students and get them experience working hands-on with patients.
It was my first experience as a volunteer to really learn how to do a physical exams and do health screenings. And looking back into it, I was very passionate about the populations I was able to work with and the coordinators that really taught me the skills.
And I just love that population. I think the women are so resilient, and their stories can be heartbreaking, but their strength is something to be admired. And they inspire me, and they inspire me to want to go study and become the best doctor that I can be.
I used to work with injecting drug users, sex workers, various different people who are struggling with housing, various people of color who have been incredibly stigmatized. So knowing that there was a space at Drexel where we learned how to actually deliver medicine to that population was incredibly meaningful to me.
I learned to treat my patient as a person, not as a disease. And managing a chronic illness is not a simple thing to fight on their own. And sometimes they need a supporter. As a physician, I will always be overseeing that.
I had some issues with addiction in my family, and I felt the best way to give back to the community would be working hands-on with a disease that I was familiar with.
I really enjoy working with underserved population. As an immigrant myself, I really feel connected to patients that, you know, have faced similar challenges that I have overcome.
And I truly can't imagine my medical school experience without HOP.
I'm Dr. David Wagner. Students around here all call me Wags, which I enjoy, and or Dr. Wags if they have to be formalized for some reason. And I go back to the days of Women's Medical College, which was an institution formed for the under-resourced in medicine at that time. And I think that characteristic and that, if you want to call it, genetic educational code has extended to this current setup that we have with Drexel University as Drexel University College of Medicine. And in particular, the HOP clinics offer this window into who we really are as a faculty and student body in terms of our mission and commitment to serve and work with the under-resourced.